Welcome into the Monday episode of the David Hookstead Show. Happy to have you all here. Obviously, we only had three episodes last week. We did release our interview with Jack O'Callaghan on Sunday night. We got another one coming up with another player of the Miracle on Ice team at some point this week. But one of the first things I want to jump into today, is Jack O'Callaghan's thoughts on athletes' protests. I'm going to read you to them. If you have not seen the full interview, it's about 28 minutes long. It's very good. He's a very interesting, fascinating individual. You can listen to it all on dailycaller.com. This is what he said about athletes protesting. It makes me sick to my stomach, actually. I think athletes should go out, should just go play and shut up. It's like actors and Hollywood types, and these athletes, their egos get bigger than, I couldn't really understand what he said there. They think people are really interested in what they have to say. I'm not really that interested. I like to see them compete. I like to see them play for their teams, play hard, go home, and be thankful they have the opportunity as opposed to be bitching and moaning about things. That's just kind of my view of it. Then he, a little further, he said, just shut up, shut your mouth and play. That's kind of my motto. So obviously, Jack O'Callaghan's an old school guy. He played on the 1980 Miracle on Ice team. That was 42 years ago, coming up on 42 years ago at this point. So it's been a long time. He's an older gentleman. Very nice gentleman, very fascinating individual. But here's the thing. That point of view that he said to me during our interview is shared by the majority of Americans. The idea, what we've allowed essentially ESPN and other networks to convince us, and people in the media and writers in the media convince us, is that actually we love protesting when athletes protest. We love when athletes take a knee. We love when athletes criticize police officers. That's what they want you to believe. That's what they want the public to believe. That's what they want you to think is happening. But in reality, the majority of Americans do not feel that way. The majority of sports fans absolutely do not feel that way. The majority of sports fans are hardworking, good people. You know, they work their 40-hour week job, whatever it might be. And then on Sunday, maybe they get 3 hours a weekend to watch some football. They just want to sit back and watch football. They don't want to be lectured by multimillionaire athletes about how they're actually the oppressors and the millionaire athletes are the victims. That's not at all what people want to hear. It's not what people want to see. And if you look at the NBA, the NBA is essentially collapsed, right? Compared to what it was 10 years ago. The ratings are down. No one cares. No one's watching. The league, to a large degree, has become a bit of a joke. And why is that? Well, the league went all in. It threw all its chips in on being woke as all hell. Okay, that's what the NBA's become. That's just the fact of the matter. Now you can disagree with that. You can say, well, no, maybe it's okay to be woke. Maybe it's okay to go all in on the BLM movement. Maybe it's okay to be anti-police. But the numbers speak for themselves. And Adam Silver, the commissioner of the NBA, even came out and said in the 2020 in the bubble that this is not working. Fans don't want to see this. They don't love how political this stuff has gotten. They hate it. Same thing with the NFL. Now, the NFL's ratings are at a six-year high, and one person thought maybe that was because they've stopped going woke. That's not really the case, because remember, they still have all the helmet decals. They have the field nonsense. I think what has happened, though, is the TV broadcast, the channels, they've decided, hey, look, we're not showing this. We're not going to promote this. We want the ratings. We want the money. We're not going to get involved in this. But the fact of the matter is this, folks. People don't like woke nonsense. Everything that goes woke turns to shit. That's a fact. So if you protest the cops, middle America will turn on you. If you protest the military, middle America will turn on you. If you protest the flag, middle America will turn on. Now, you'll always have some loons on the coast who think communism's awesome and think Fidel Castro's great and who thinks Colin Kaepernick is a modern day hero. You know, he's like Jesus Christ himself. You'll always have crazy people like that. The fact of the matter is this, and it could not be any more accurate. People don't want to see that shit. It's 100% true. You can disagree with it all you want, but it is 100% true. People do not want to see it. And when they see it, they're going to get upset. So that's where we're at with that. And I thought Jack O'Callaghan's comments, quite frankly, were on point. In my mind, they made a hell of a lot of sense. All right, the Cowboys lost to the 49ers 23-17 Sunday night. on what might be the dumbest single play call I've ever seen in the history of the NFL, on what they thought was going to be their second to last play. There's 14 seconds left. They're on the 41. They run a QB draw with no timeouts. Dak gets them up to like what, about the 25-ish, roughly in there. And the ref then runs into them while setting the ball so they can't spike it. Clock hit zero. Game's over. Unbelievably stupid. One of the dumbest sequence of events I've ever seen in my life from a pro sports team, ever. You run a QB draw with 14 seconds left in the game and no timeouts. What did you think was going to happen? What did you think was going to happen on a QB draw with 14 seconds left and no timeouts? Seriously, what was Dallas's plan there? If anything had gone wrong, the clock was going to hit zero. Now, granted, it's not Dak Prescott's fault that the ref ran into him. I don't even know how that happens. But the point of the matter is you shouldn't be running a QB draw with 14 seconds and no timeouts left to begin with. That was abysmal. That was some of the worst play call. I don't know if you want to put that on Mike McCarthy, if you want to put that on Kellen Moore, whoever you want to put that on. That was one of the most pathetic decisions I've ever seen in the history of the NFL. Ever. It was abysmal, disgusting. Fans should be outraged. I know fans were throwing stuff on the field. I don't know if they were frankly throwing it just at the refs or at the players. Whoever it was, absolutely unacceptable sequence of events. Terrible. Bill Belichick says he will not retire. He will return. He will coach in the 2022 season. I think this was obvious. Now, they got blown out by the Bills on Saturday night. They got absolutely crushed. It looked like boys versus men out there. And then he obviously got asked if he was going to return. He said he was going to return. He said, I think his exact quote was, that would be accurate when asked if he'd be back in 2022. All the way around, just, you can't go out like that. When you're a living legend like Bill Belichick, you simply can't go out with a loss like that. Makes all the perfect sense. The question now is, where can the Patriots go up? The Bills clearly appear to be in control of the AFC East. But they have Mac Jones. They have a young quarterback. Obviously, Bill Belichick's won 6 Super Bowl rings with the Pats. So you can't rule him out. You can't rule him out at all. But it'll be interesting. Good to know he's not retiring. All right, a leaked photo shows Caleb Williams wearing a USC uniform. Now, everyone thinks the former Oklahoma quarterback is going to transfer, okay, is going to transfer to USC to play again with Lincoln Riley. The leaked photo seems to indicate that that is absolutely what's going to happen. I don't have a ton to say about this. I think a lot of us have expected it to happen, and now it could become official at any moment in time. What I will say is this. Good for Lincoln Riley. He's got his quarterback. USC needs a good quarterback. He's found his guy. So it looks like they're going to be in a good position to win going forward. This is one of my favorite stories of the past week. Kayvon Thibodeau, the Oregon player, star, soon to be top 5 NFL pick most likely. He trashed the University of Alabama's education. Okay, so essentially said is, if he went there, his degree would be worthless. You know, he said it ain't the West Coast. It ain't Harvard. Oregon ain't Harvard either. So I don't really know why he chose to pick on Alabama there. But Greg McElroy, former Alabama quarterback, ESPN pundit, ESPN star, he challenged him to an IQ test and the Wonderlic. He said you can take one or the other. And here's the reality of the situation, folks. I know a decent amount of people from the state of Alabama. I know a decent amount of people who went to the University of Alabama. You got... It's like anything else in life. You got some smart people. You got some dumb people. You got a large group in the middle. But that applies everywhere. And the idea that people who go to Alabama somehow aren't intelligent, or that a University of Alabama degree is worthless compared to a University of Oregon degree, is just laughable. And then he made simple grammatical errors while trashing the University of Alabama. He's talking about how he doesn't want to be a dumb jock. And then he makes simple mistakes like talking about, I believe he incorrectly said the stigma of the school. He said the stigmatized of the program. Just look, there's dumb people at every school in America. There's really smart people at every school in America. And there's a lot of people in between. Kayvon Thibodeau might be trending in the wrong direction than he thinks he's trending in, judging by the comments he made. And good for Greg McElroy. I mean, you can't take that shit lying down. You can't let someone just walk all over your program, trash your program, and not say anything. You got to get up and say something. You got to get up and do something. So props to him. I agree with it 100%. I like it. I mean, I thought it was good to hit back, good to hit back hard. Finally, this is awesome. As you all know, I'm a huge Justified fan. I think Justified is one of the greatest TV shows ever made. I think Timothy Olyphant was excellent in it, absolutely outstanding in it. And now it is coming back for a limited series. I think it's going to be called Justified City of Primeval. Let me look. I want to make sure I'm getting this right. Justified FX. All right, what is it called? It is Justified City. I don't even really know how to pronounce this. I'm gonna not pretend to be Thibodeau. It's gonna be City Primeval. I assume it's Primeval. But it sounds awesome. Timothy Olyphant's returning. Obviously, he did six seasons as Raylan Givens, the U.S. Marshal. You won't get Walton Goggins because Boyd's been in prison this whole time, so obviously he can't come out. I hope we get Art back. I hope Nick Searcy returns. I hope we get to see a lot of the old characters again. But man, I could not be more excited. I think it's going to be super cool. I love Justified. It's one of the best shows ever made. Raylan and Boyd on screen together was always incredible, always outstanding. So anyways, I encourage you all to watch my interview with Jack Callahan. Watch the next one we got coming up. And anyways, that's all we have for the Monday episode of the David Hookstead Show. Check back Tuesday for an all new one.